Namaskar, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome to the fourth episode of Bhairavi Swarajati. Today we are going to discuss about the fourth and the fifth charanam of this beautiful composition. In the fourth charanam of this Bhairavi Swarajati, the lyrics goes like this. Bhakta jana kalpalatika karunalaya sadaya giritanaya kavave sharanagatudugada tamasamu seyaka varamu osagu. Bhakta jana, the devotees, kalpalatika, the wish fulfilling creeper in the Indra's paradise, karunalaya, the most compassionate, sadaya, always. Here the goddess Kamakshi is compared to the Kalpalatika and the most compassionate one who fulfills all the wishes of her devotees. Giritanaya, she who is the daughter of Himavan. Kavave, please protect me. Sharanagatudugada, have I not surrendered to you? Tamasamu seyaka, without any further delay. Varamu osagu, please grant me all the boons. Kama kshi amba ma panida ma pada pa ma gari ga ma pa ga ma pa ma panida ma pada pa ma gari ga ma pa ga ma pa ga pa ma gari ni sa ri ni sa ri ni sa ri ga ma pa da ni sa pa sa ni ra pa ma gari ka ma kshi amba. Kalpalatika karunalaya sadaya amba bhakta jana kalpalatika karunalaya sadaya giritanaya kavave sharana gatudugada tamasamu seyaka varamu osagu. Bhaktajana kalpalatika karunalaya sadaya giritanaya kavave sharana gatudugada tamasamu seyaka varamu osagu. Kama kshi amba. In the fifth charana, the lyrics goes like this. Pataka mulanu virchini pada bhakti santatam iyave pavanikada moravinada parakelanamma vinamma. Patakamulanu, all the sins. Here the Shama Shastri says that she is the remover of all the sins. Pada bhakti santatam iyave, please give me the complete devotion and bhakti. Pavanikada, are you not the purest one? Moravinada, will you not listen to my entreaties? Parakelanamma, why do you turn your face away from me? Vinamma, please listen to me.
Pada pa ma gari ga ma pa ma gari ga ma gari ni sa ri ga ma gari sa pa ma gari sa ri
Kamakshi removes all the sins of the previous birth of Mukakavi and blesses him.
Shiva Shiva Pashyanti Samam Shri Kamakshi Katakshita Purusha Vipinam Bhavananam Amitram Mitram Loshtam Cha Yuvati Bimboshatam. Great men blessed by the Kataksha of Kamakshi regard with equal unconcern forest and palace, foe and friend, a piece of stone and the captivating lips of damsels. What a wonder, O Shiva, O Shiva!
These are the verses taken from the first Shatakam of the Arya Shatakam from Mukha Panchashati, written by Mukha Kavi. Who is this Mukha? Is he a common man or a great poet? The word Mukha means a person who cannot talk or a person born mute. According to a story propagated from generations after generations, there was a great poet called Kalidasa. Kalidasa was a great poet and was considered a gem amongst the other great poets like Tandi and Bhavabhuti in Bhojaraja's royal court. Once there was a debate among the great poets as who was the best. At that moment, the goddess Kali herself appeared in front of them and declared that Tandi and Bhavabhuti were the great poet. This annoyed Kalidasa and out of arrogance disrespects the Devi. Devi punished Kalidasa to be born mute in his next janma as Mukha Kavi. Kalidasa, realizing his mistake, pleaded to the Devi, and by her grace he is blessed to get back his powers of talking and even sing poetries in praise of her in the next janma. In another story, the Acharya of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam along with his Sishyas used to visit the Kamakshi Amman temple to perform the Nitya Puja for the Devi. There was this mute person, Mukha, who assisted the Acharya in bringing the water for the Abhishekam and arranging the various things required for the Puja every day. One day, the Acharya had gone on a pilgrimage far away and could not return back during the time of Abhishekam. Mukha waited for his Acharya in front of the Vigraham of Kamakshi. That was when the miracle happened. Mukha could notice the lips of the goddess Kamakshi moving and soon realized that the goddess Kamakshi was sitting in front of him dressed in beautiful silk sari and fine jewelry, an infinite compassion flowing out of her eyes. He noticed that the goddess was chewing betel leaf. She smeared her hand with the juice from her lips and applied it on Mukha's tongue. And all of a sudden, when he opened his mouth, he realized that he could speak, and he raised his hand in praise of the goddess and fell at her feet, only to notice that she had vanished. Such was the compassion of goddess Kamakshi. The Mukha was blessed by the supreme knowledge of the Vedas, and when he opened his mouth, he could sing at the glories and the praises of goddess Kamakshi in beautiful verses as the Mukha Panchashati. The Acharya, acknowledging that the goddess herself has shown her compassion and grace on Mukha, made Mukha the 20th Acharya of the Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam and named him the Mukha Shankarendra Saraswati Swamigad.
పాతకమూలను తీర్చి నీ पशुपते राकारिणी राजते సంపద మీయవే పావని గదా మోర వినదా పరాకేలనమ్మా వినమ్మా మా